Hello, my name is Anthony Hall and this is a basic introduction to using the lathe tool in Lightwave 3D. So I've started off by collecting some images that I'm going to use as a backdrop so I can draw around them and then use the lathe tool to make the objects. So I'm going to start by going to Edit, Backdrop Options, and I'm going to use this bottom right hand view, so bottom right, and then I'm going to load in one of the images. So I'll start off by just, we'll use this candlestick here to start off with. So as you can see, we've got it here in the background. When we draw around it, if it's quite a light image like this, you might want to invert it so their points show up, because I'm not actually using it for anything else apart from drawing around. You can also change the darkness of it if you want, and also the size of it, but I'm going to stick like this with everything. Shut that down. I'm just going to maximize my right window, and then what I'm going to do is draw around the actual side profile of the actual candlestick to lathe. So to do that, I'll use the create tab, and we'll go down to, say, let's try spleen draw, and we'll start from the top. And then I'm going to start making and wrapping around the side. So press space bar, say I'm happy with that. Once you've done it, if you want, you can zoom in, and then if you hold alt you can move your actual screen, and then you can go to modify drag, and you can drag the points and place them better if you wish. So I'm just holding the alt to go down, because I'm doing it quite quickly, so my suggestion is to take your time with this so you get the similar profile. What we've got is the outline of the candle. So next, what we do is go to modify lathe. I'm going to press N on the keyboard and it will lathe it. Now currently it's lathing it inside out, so if I just go back and press F on my keyboard to flip the polyline, and then use the numerical again down here, look, you can see it's lathed it round, and you can add more segments. It means it's got 24 currently, so you can add more, or again you can go quite low if you wanted to make it look more like this. But we'll stick with, say, 24, and spacebar, and then under the surface editing we just put smoothing on, and what we've got is our first object. So we'll do it again, but on another object now. So in a new layer, we're going to go to Edit, Backdrop Options, bottom right, choose, and let's choose a wine glass like so, and let's draw around that. So if we go back to create, there are other options. So the Bezier tool, what that does is when you click and drag, you get the handles, so you can move and manipulate with the handles the actual curve. So again, it adds more points. You bring the numerical up, you can decide how many points in between each one. So if we put 8, it will reduce them to 8, and again you can decide on how you want this to go down. I find this one quite time consuming. And then obviously you carry on all the way round, to the bottom, and then what you would do with this, we can come up to the center and then go around back on itself, so it's a closed curve, so we get an inside and out. But I'm just gonna get rid of that because it takes a bit longer. You've got the sketch. Now the sketch is just like a freehand, so you draw around, but again you don't get it perfect if you go quite quick. But what you can do is you can go in, use the drag tool, and you can straighten all these up like so. But what I'll do is we'll stick to the spleen draw, and I'm gonna when I get to the top, we'll bring numerical up and we'll close the curve so it's closed. Press space bar, and then this is the time when you can, because I've rushed it, you can go in with the modifying drag and you can start straightening these up, trying to make it so the length of each one is right. So don't be frightened to zoom all the way in. And what I'll do is speed the video up so you don't have to watch me do every single bit. Okay, so I've drew all the way around the actual wine glass and I've come back on myself and then made it a closed curve. So I'm now ready to lathe this. So like before, I'm going to press F on the keyboard to flip the polyline, go to lathe, numerical, and bring up the wine glass. Now you can see there's some imperfections on it in the actual wine glass. That's because I haven't took my time to actually really line up all the polys, but the points. But this is something you can easily do if you take your time, but I just don't want to spend too much time on this. So again, that's another way of creating another object. So we'll do what we'll do is I'll do one more, but this time what I'll do is show you how you can use it to make maybe a spring. So what I'll do is I'll go to edit, backdrop options, and I'll just remove the image. So the way the lathe works is it lathes around the center point. So if I was to put, say, a disc here, let me just put it in the bottom, a disc, say, here. Let's say I move it to there. That's where it would lathe from, around wherever it's placed in position to the center. So if I go to the lathe and bring up numerical, if I wanted to make a simple ring, that's where I would lathe from. And then once it's done, you drop the selection, you press F on your keyboard and it will flip it. So again, there's that way. If we just undo that, so let's say I wanted to make a large spring, so if I just move this in slightly, let's lathe it again. Just flip it first. But this time, let's say where it says end angle, what I want to do is I want it to lathe it 10 times 360. So I'm going to put 10 times 360 return. But what I also want to do is I want to give it more points, so I'm just going to put a zero on the end and I'm going to offset it, say 10 meters up in the air. So what it's doing is offsetting it up 10 meters by 10 times 360. So if I want that to go higher, so there's gaps in between it, let's put 15. So then you get this, based on 240 polygons. So could I get away with less? Well, let's try 100. So, to be honest, we could get away with it because we could subpatch it. So let's bring it down to 70. And what I'll do is commit. And then what I'll do is I'll press the tab key to subpatch it. Now it's giving me an error because the ends aren't set up right, which is not too, it's not the end of the world. But what we've got is by putting just 50 polys to separate each of the levels, it brings the polygon size down, but also you can subpatch it to make your spring as well. So that's another way you could make use of using the lathe tool there. So hopefully this tutorial's helped, and thanks for listening.